So this one touches on voter turnout and participation in Canada's electoral system. We mentioned about capacity and getting involved, but as climate change is often a slightly bipartisan topic currently, or in general, how do you want to engage youth to go out there and participate and engage in politics or engage in climate politics? And how would you encourage increased voter turnout regardless of ideology?
I think very quickly, I'd say, again, like illustrating perhaps a little bit about the impacts of politics and this kind of leadership and the impact and the influence this has, and that for folks, if they do vote, whoever may be the elected leadership, their vote has an impact. And perhaps, again, an illustration of a contrast of a green future versus an alternative, and just knowing that their voices, all youth voices, are really needed to be heard. And if we are looking to create that change, it's important to speak up, and that they're not alone. There's a whole community of people who are looking to create that brighter future, and their vote does matter.
Yeah, I can share a few like stats and things related to like the voice mattering, which it does. Young people actually have the biggest voter base. They can sway the vote, at least in the federal election. If every young person voted, we could sway things quite significantly. And I was quite active in the past snap election. I'm actually probably should have mentioned this another time on this panel, but I'm on the shadow cabinet for the Green Party of Canada. So I was working on environmental policy and kind of bringing in that psychology element a few times as well. And yeah, we found that young people, it's kind of frustrating. It's kind of like stigmatized a little bit that voting isn't cool still. And I actually think voting is the most incredible thing you can ever do. And when the election comes around, like I try to speak to as many young people as I can, especially on social media, about why is it that your vote actually does count? Because I think a lot of people think that their vote won't sway things. But if we have the biggest voter base of young people and that they have the biggest impact, we can show them that it is capable, you are capable of changing things. And I think there is an education piece along with that as well. I think we need to do better at educating young people about why politics are important and how to vote, and maybe create less stigma related to that. There's an amazing organization. I cannot for the life of me think of the name, but I interacted with them a lot when I was living in Ontario about trying to get like better voting literacy and trying to get less stigma and skepticism about like the experience of voting. And I think getting that into schools and universities and colleges and teaching people about why it's important to vote and how to vote would definitely help.
Super quick last thing to add is we need to lower the voting age to 16. That's something I feel very, very strongly about. But I will only just support what my other panelists have said because they really covered all the other pieces, but we need to lower the voting age to 16. I think that would make a huge difference. And like Beth, like you were saying, like it could also like make voting cool again. Like if we get, you know, a whole new wave of like young people who are kind of excited about going to vote and stuff, that does influence upwards as well.
I was actually, this is going to be a slightly augmented question for Stella, just because, correct me if I'm wrong, you have yet to be able to vote. You're still under 18. So I was wondering, what are your thoughts, not only on engaging in elections, but also engaging that under 18 demographic as well?
Yeah, I'm not able to vote. I'm only 17. But I would love to vote. I'd love to be able to kind of share my opinion. And I often just talk to my peers about how important it is to vote and that their one vote does matter. I think that we need to stress that more so than not, as well as just learning at school, like how to vote, how that works, learning the different views from different angles of what the beliefs are for the parties. Because we don't really learn about that. I know about politics from my parents at the supper table. That's usually our topic of the night is always around world problems and what's going on with politics. And I think that's really important, is to just have that open conversation with what's going on in the world.